Hey everyone, how's it going today? And welcome back to another third stimulus check unemployment, or I guess you may even be able to say fourth stimulus package update. Because in today's update, I pretty much want to talk about this like brand new bill that's kind of been floating around. The general idea is that President Biden is going to be introducing a brand new bill that's going to be released next week. Now, of course, because of that reason, we don't have the official bill. However, there are details about what we can speculate that's supposedly going to be inside of that bill. So in today's update, I really just want to talk about what to expect about this brand new bill. Now, I think it's important to make clear is that there are no stimulus checks inside of this bill. There are certain things that will maybe impact certain parts of our life. And there are also other potential programs, because at the end of the day, the big thing to notice is, and I think sometimes the meaning is kind of mixed around, but like a stimulus package at the end of the day, as the definition stands, is that it's meant to stimulate the economy. So even though this package maybe doesn't have stimulus checks, there are still things in this package that can potentially stimulate the economy, but just simply in other ways. So we're going to talk all about what's potentially going to be in this bill. There are some ways that it may potentially impact unemployment, especially not necessarily the unemployment plan per se, but just unemployment as a big picture. But it's going to make a lot more sense if you guys are just by any chance curious and wondering, because there were a lot of questions about, are we getting a fourth stimulus package or something like that? So we're going to cover it all in today's video. But before we begin, make sure you smash the like button, especially in light of a lot of the recent approvals and that we're finally getting the ball rolling. Consider subscribing if you're interested in just videos like this and other finance topics. And as always, feel free to comment any questions, thoughts about honestly just really anything at all, or if you wanted to say hi, always great to see familiar faces and also new faces if you guys are brand new here. Consider subscribing for that. So with that being said, let's just get started right on the spot. Now, before we begin, the new unemployment claims recently did just come out, so I want to really just quickly cover them. But basically, last week we received report that about 684,000 people filed for traditional unemployment, 242,000 people filed for PUA unemployment. So the general idea is that if you've been following what the unemployment situation is like in this country, for the very, very first time, I believe, since the pandemic started, the weekly claims for traditional unemployment fell below 700,000 people, and I believe the total amount of unemployment, including PUA, for the very first time since last year, right around this time of year, fell below 1 million people. So this really does show that in a lot of ways is that this economy is recovering in that sense. Now, we will touch up a little bit about how this might potentially impact things just in a little bit, but the general idea is that what's going on next week is that President Biden is going to be introducing a new infrastructure plan. Some people say it's like a stimulus-related plan, because at the end of the day, it is meant to stimulate or improve the economy in that sense. But regardless of what you're calling it, let's just say Biden's plan is that it's supposed to be an infrastructure plan that's supposed to cost right around $3 trillion. I believe he's introducing it in Pittsburgh, and it's supposedly going to be introduced either Tuesday or Wednesday, but something around the middle of this week. Now, what's exactly in this bill is that there's several parts in this bill. Probably, as most of you guys can probably suggest just based off of the name of the bill, is that most of this bill is pretty much going to be spent on pretty much improving all of the infrastructure and clean energy related stuff inside of our country. So things, examples of this could be like roads, highways, buildings, construction, energy, and this is actually particularly going to influence daily life. So maybe not necessarily it's going to necessarily put money inside of your pocket, although there may be actually some ways, which we're going to touch up on in a little bit. This is even more true because when you guys live your daily life, you guys probably do a lot of different things. Like if you happen to be driving down roads, enjoying scenery, it's actually especially impactful because most of last year, if you guys remember, depending on where you're from, we've had a lot of cases of things like natural disasters, power lines cutting, fires, hurricanes, buildings being destroyed, roads being environmental. Mental issues, energy, water, anything like that. So in a lot of ways is that this bill is going to potentially save that. And I mean, the big thing to notice is that because of a lot of these natural disasters, there were a lot of people last year that ended up actually in even more financial tightness because they had to afford to be able to pay for so many different things. If not impacted in terms of finances, certainly if anything in terms of lifestyle. So this bill is hoping to improve the quality of life for for the majority of us. Now, there are also a lot of other programs that's potentially going to impact us financially. So, for example, they are also hoping to give a lot of money to things related to schools and education. So, if you happen to work in the education industry, this could potentially impact you. But probably even more relatable is that there are a lot of talks right now, and again, this is speculation. We don't know because it's not confirmed because the bill hasn't physically come out yet, but there have certainly been, from a lot of his speeches, a lot of intention to potentially try to cover or waive student loans. So if you happen to be a student of some kind and you happen to have loans, they're hoping to maybe, again, this is all speculation, we don't know if it's in this specific bill, because they might be either putting it in this bill or maybe even in a future bill, but there is a chance they may be doing something to waive student loans. But I know almost certain is that there's definitely going to be something to influence education. I do believe that there also talks about trying to make community college for free. So anyone that happens to be a student, there's a lot of ways that this can potentially save, if anything, several thousands and thousands of dollars inside of our pocket. The other huge one that's interesting, and again, this is also speculation right now, is about potentially trying to extend the child tax credit. So if you happen to be a parent and you happen to have a child, or once again, if maybe you happen to be that child and you're interested in this, maybe you can show this to your parents. And I did, again, make another previous video about this, which I also put at the end screen. I think it's physically called Extra $3,000 or Extra $3,600, because the current child tax credit program is supposed to put an extra about $3,000 to $3,600 in every single family's pocket per child. There are a lot of talks right now about potentially trying to maybe, again, the keyword is maybe because the bill hasn't come out yet, trying to maybe create some kind of extension to make this child tax credit last even longer than what it currently has right now. And probably the other thing that's probably going to also be interesting is that they're also hoping to potentially try now, and this is something they're almost definitely going to do, is going to be to increase taxes. Now, the great news is I think that he's trying to only increase taxes on people that are either making an income of over $400,000 or more. However, they may also try to raise the taxes for corporations. Now, this part maybe will indirectly impact us, and we're going to talk a little bit about how it can potentially impact unemployment or the job market in a little bit. But for the majority of us, I think the great news is that if, especially if you happen to be someone that's following stimulus news, then you probably, you know, off of that logic, are making, if anything, probably less than $75,000. So probably significantly less, if anything, than the $400,000 that Biden is trying to set as the income starting point for when taxes are going to start raising. Now, in terms of how this can potentially impact unemployment, because I also know there were some people that were wondering if it's possible we can maybe see another additional unemployment extension into something beyond this summer. The general answer is that it might be a little bit hard to tell right now. However, what goes into this package can potentially actually impact it, because, for example, by doing a lot of the infrastructure projects, the great news is that if you happen to work in the construction industry, and I'm a little bit biased because interestingly, some people actually know this about me, but before I started working and doing what I'm doing right now, years ago, I actually used to work in the construction industry. You probably have walked inside of a building that I've probably made at some point, especially if you are in New York City. But the general idea is that if you happen to work in any of those industries, it can potentially try to create more jobs. If more jobs are created, then it's going to potentially solve the unemployment situation, which means that there's going to be less likely to be a chance of a further unemployment extension. Now, on another note, though, is that there's also the other side of the argument that because they're hoping to maybe increase taxes, if they increase taxes, there is a chance that it may be making it even harder for a lot of corporations to survive. And if that ends up doing, especially because of how many jobs have already been basically lost after most of last year from all of the business closures, then there is a chance that because of that reason, there may be actually even more companies that maybe go down under, and because of that reason, it may actually impact unemployment even more so, because now it's going to potentially make a lot of corporate companies to hire less people. So it kind of goes maybe in both ways. I guess maybe feel free to share your opinion, because again, like, the worse the unemployment situation is, the more likely we will see more extensions, but at the same time, it also means that the more longer we're probably going to stay unemployed. So depending on what you're basically looking for, whether you want to go back to work or you want to get more benefits, and it really just depends on your current situation, how you look at it. But based on the unemployment numbers right now, it does look like that we are currently going to be making a recovery. So that is pretty much just something to really keep in mind, especially now with this infrastructure bill. It may potentially create even more jobs, but it just kind of depends on which way it kind of swings more towards. But that's pretty much what I wanted to cover in today's update, because some people were wondering about that and trying to get a little bit more clarification. We will probably know a lot more about this bill maybe next week, so maybe consider subscribing if you guys are interested in that. And also, of course, again, like other kinds of finance topics, I'll put a couple videos at the end. If you guys are brand new here, consider subscribing. Remember to smash the like button if you guys hopefully did. And with that being said, thank you guys so much for watching. Stay safe, stay well, and have an incredible weekend or weekday, depending on when you are watching this. Thank you guys so much again, and hope to see you guys next time.